In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The humbling conversion of Saul. Ing makapaglating pamagbayo na lug Saul. King kaya katangmo mo ng pamamasa, rimdam tayo ing meto nga maupayang tao. The proud Saul. Mata siya lug. At hindi sigurong dahilan para magmata sa lug. Uling mayupayaya. Ing kayang misyon, kayang mumunang pamamasa, mumuntaya Damascus para kwananala retang maniwala kang Kristo. Those who follow the way and they're taking him by chain. Kwananala denggang tutugi kang Kristo, ikaladkad nala pakatanikalala. O iteng kayang misyon king aldong ite. Berdugo ya, brutal ya, he's a bully, persecutor, Saul. Pero lawenta mo'y kayang pamagbayo nung makanaanong milyari. Muna, kabud ng ditang masikan, masikan, at masalang, masalang, tinud kaya. Papuntaya pa Damasco, ating tinud na masala kaya, at menabuya. We assume panaya pong makakabayo, San Pablo, king kayang pamaglakbe, he fell to the ground. Falling is like failing. It is an embarrassing moment for big and successful people, those who are intelligent and outstanding, individuals of success, when they are not used at falling and unaccustomed, they're not accustomed in failing. E da po kalupa rin ordinaryong tao, paldak si karanan ng swerte, ng kay mga pakarine ka, ng kay magkamali ka mas madalas, akit mo yung kayalan mo. Pero po tang meto kang taong mata sa loob, the proud Saul, may nabuya kayang kayang kabayo. Karang magkwao, intindyan din. Ne, apusale. Potang may nabuha kayong kabayo, maragul kabayaran. Itangke kang dapat kabiran, bayaran mo metong-metong, dingge kong kalaban. Burin sabihan, may kamali ka, kalyanda ka, itang masakit yan. Bala mo, sinambot na ka, kakabid ka, ika pala yung masambot, ika yung mamayaran. May nabuya kayong kayang kabayo. Neng kay bala mo di sa niyang karamalasan, malas o unfortunate, isn't it? Kita kay San Fernando, enak man po mag-promote ating meto ka restaurant ing lagyo na fortune, swerte, swerte. Itang siping ng restaurant, ana nang mamuklat siyang wine, ana nang mamuklat fine dining, ana nang manuklat na anong negosyo, panayang misasara, panayang eh magtagumpe. Nga ko pen, nung ining meto nga tindahan na ini, restaurant, ingaus da fortune, nani yung haus da ketang meto ka tindahan, nagyan nanu ng buklat, nang nanu buklat na negosyo, misasaraya. Ingaus da kanita, miss fortune. Talagang eh tutud. Bala mo, makanyan ng milyari, the misfortune experience, the misfortune experience, of Saul. He fell from the horse. May nganyang alikabok. Ngayon ni kayong tindyan, takakantada rin Queen, Freddie Mercury. Ngayon tasabihan ng another one bites the dust. May nganyang alikabok. He experienced falling. Tutuman po tang aranasan mo iti. Kadwa ing maupayang Saul, alaya nga karapat may bulag yo. He was blinded and powerless. Potang baluk bulag ka, balamu, daig may pay nga nakamalati, ala ka nga kakit. Potang kasing masyado ka sigurado kay MBM mo. Potang nga kasana yung magkamali. Nang kaya pansinan mo, makabulag mo naman, ing masyadong bilib kay sarili. Apansin niyo po, deng entrepreneurs, deng negosyanteng matagumpe, deng successful negosyante. kanakwa ti kung akakwentong madakala negosyante, kaysa bienda po, I'm a successful businessman, but I'm not the best in the school. I'm not the valedictorian. I'm not even a salutatorian. Kaya mamirula pa, baliktorian ko. May bagsak ko. Ekman, biasa. Simply lamo, den taong maging matagumpe. Elaman summa cum laude. Elaman magna cum laude. Elaman cum laude. Sanelang magkamali. Sanelang paldaksikara na ning kasakitan kay pamagaral. But they are used to these realities. Anya po at ang sanekang magkamali, katatakot, subukan mo pang pasibayin, kaya kasusuko, as at even when you fall, but you do not give up, o rendeng maging matagumpe, entrepreneurs. Pero itang biyasang-biyasa, di mo rin kaklasiko, biyasang-biyasa, nang kay, at chula kayong opisina. Bakit? Kasi kayong opisina, tingang cubicle, ingawan mo kayong patingapon, it's already outlined, you will not experience much mistake. Ing makatakot ka rin biyasa, edaya tanggap impamagkamali. When they cannot accept, there are times that they are also wrong. Riding high, the pride of temporary success and power and fame, towards you discover what is truly essential. Paul was blinded only to see clearly. May bulag ya, I Pablo, bang nang akit mas malino, ing dapat nang akit. He was blinded by a great light, or maybe because Paul lived in darkness. Since I could see nothing because of the brightness of the light, I was led by hand the companions and was entering Jerusalem. Aranasan nyo nito keng sobrang sala, e mo na yakakit. Potang magmaneo ka kong money, potang kayarap mo maka-bright ya, keng sobrang sala, you are always almost blinded. Makanya siguro, ing akasagana ng Pablo, keng mabiebieya keng dalumdum, nyantang akasagana ng tulay masala, alus e naikit. Aga nakakaya po itang idol kung metong German F1 champion. Ita pong F1, tangpe karang mabilis sa akin. Ing lagyo na po, Michael Schumacher. Maganakane man po ini, biasa yan, humble yan. Pero peka mabilis yan, karang hanggang magmaneho sa akin. Dakal yan po trophy, milyonaryo yan po. Kabilis na ang kabilis. Potang magmaneho yan, panen champion. Riding high, riding fast. In fact, the fastest. Pero itong 2013 December, Schumacher, mika traumatic brain injury. Eman king kayang pamagmaneo. Eman kitang mabilis sa pilan 100 miles, pupulay, alipo. Bali po na ni kay aksidente, mag-skiya mo. Poteng snow, mag-skiya. At may aksidente, kayang pamag-skiya na. May pupukya buntok. Hindi ako magkamali kayang tanaman hanggang ngayon po. Iyan pa po fully recovered. May coma ya. And for some many, many years, and po may kapagbalik. At balo tayo mo, the oldest fall of man. The proud Adam and Eve. It took the sacrifice of Jesus, the humble Son of God, to bring back our identity because of this salvation. The brutal bully, verdugo, persecutor, Saul, suddenly he realized he needed help. Kasi kangko, verdugo ko, baga mo bully, ako yung mami, ako yung taga-bugbog, ako yung kakatakutan da. Ngenirugo, tatariyande, susopande, e makarina ita, e masakit ita. Anggyang iPedro, kanitang mamagmayabang iya, ha, ginuwa lang pwedeng talan keka, dakapaburen. Hanggang yantang yamismo ikit na, He was so weak that the times Jesus was carrying the cross, may katalunay pikalunong. Anya balami nga pakarine yan naman ni Pedro kaya kayang sika na nalub. Ang po kayang ketasa nalub. Hanggang niya ta sinabi na, feed my sheep. Someday, Peter, when you will be old, luwang mo rin gaman mo, tarianda ka, imambalo nung kamunta, imamburi nung kamunta, uling content, kanminyan, makanyan talaga, impain tungol din tao. This great man, Paul, Saul, and Peter, they were humbled in their own conversion, and yet they were rescued to realize they need help. Baloy po, makanano yung tanggapan, inke kayong pamagbayulob, potang tinggap mo ng kailangan mo yung saup ng Diyos. Potang kailangan mo na yung saup da rin aliwa. When you are humbled by your own weakness, akit mo kayong pagmayabang mong sikanan, eman pala manatiliti. Ay, akong peka masakon. Akong peka ala ko sakit. Pero datang yung panahon, ako migagan na ka, datang karing ka rin. Bali po, malambat na ako pong maglanya. I was anointing people left and right, especially when I was assigned in San Fernando, because St. Jude was surrounded by so many hospitals. And ako man po chaplain, but from time to time, I was called to anoint, lalo na kanita ka lang COVID. You know what I realized? Ninurempe ka masakit, masakit. The most painful experience of anointing are those people who were powerful before. Panamdaman mo'y sakit na rin lalanyan mo, potang akit mo'y tsura. You look into their eyes and their face. Akit mo ka rin lalanyan mo, dati lang maupaya, dati lang makwalto, dati lang ilang boss, ilang masusunod, ing amano da, masikan. Pero dating panahon, potang makarate nala, ing masakit karela. What is difficult for those who are strong and successful and powerful, it's not only their illness. Misa natikulinan yan. Kasi ka na. Itong tinas na yung gamat na, may buklating negosyo. Baba na yung gamat na, may sara yung tindahan. Tumanya niya, madeliver nga. Pangatinas na yung gamat na, tuknang langan. He's so powerful. Linanyake, may stroke yun, emigalo. When I was anointing the person, I could see, ing masakit kaya, liwaman tang may stroke yun. Ing masakit kaya, ining gamat ng mismong ini, eman maminto kaya. Ing masakit bisayin talakad, eman mi talakad. He was like a baby, makadaya perya. So painful, so humiliating. Hopefully we pray that those moments will be humbling moments of conversion. And I think this is also a realization. Ang giyang antiya kasi kanin tao, ang giyang magmayabang yang maupaya ko lang kakatugutan, nganapin Martin Luther King Jr. Darkness cannot be driven away by darkness. Only light can do that. Hate cannot drive away hate. Only love can do that. I think Saul was full of hatred, full of anger inside him, and he was converted by a humiliating experience of the light. And when he was assisted to go to Damascus, hate and hatred and hate and anger isolates. Potang mimwa kang mimwa, kakawani mo yung kakasarili keng sala. If you want to be miserable, hate somebody, because violence in your heart consumes you. Akakicho puret ang ating sakit ken dungos, deng ating sakit ken dungos. This is from a Japanese doctor and research. Inka nung sakit ken dungos, aliwa mo itang nengkay, lakang kakanan siguro, kaya acidic ka. Or sometimes, bala mo, you are being consumed by your own acidity inside. It's not only because of that at minum kang panulo, hindi. The real cause of that pain inside you is hatred. Pag nakalka ka muha, kaya pilubluban mo, you are being consumed by your own sin. And the conversion of Paul is not by violence. It's not even by other people who preach to him. If you realize this great, proud, powerful persecutor, verdugo, brutal, bully, Saul, he was converted by Jesus himself. Take note, it was not Peter, it's not about the disciples, it's not about the apostles preaching na dindamdala magbayo yap. Ikristo mismo yang magpabayo kayo. And I think the strong experience of Paul led him to be one of the greatest apostles of all time. That he was even made a co-founder of our faith. The celebration, especially the celebration of the feast of Peter and Paul, is a conversion experience of these two men. Sana po, when you have humbling experiences, when you realize that your own power, your own pride, and your own abilities will not lead you anywhere, but only when we succumb ourselves in humbling conversion before God, then can we really see true light, true power that would guide us. Let this be our good news. Let this be our challenge. May God bless us all. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.